Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name's Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is a TP-Link Omada access point. This is the EAP610. This is a 2x2 wireless 6 access point that works in the 2.4 gigahertz band and the 5 gigahertz. It's got a rating of an AX1800. That means that its total throughput is about 1.8 gigabits a second. So in the 2.4, we maybe see a maximum of 500 megasecond, and we maybe see 1.2 gig in the 5 gigahertz range. So this is great to have a number of these through your property. They are not for high density, but are for great cost price entry into the wireless 6 market. So let me show you what we get in the box. This is a TP-Link Omada. Omada is all centrally managed. There's either software to install on your computer to manage it, or your smart device, or you can buy an on-site controller, currently the OC200 and the OC300, but you will need to have installed the software to be able to get this running and configured. So you're going to get a little guide here to all the different things that are part of the Omada range, and you're going to get your quick start guide that's going to walk you through getting the app, getting everything that you actually need to plug in. Now this is PoE or mains powered, and the great thing about these TP-Link access points is they also give you the mains pack as well. We're here in Australia, probably get a couple of meters of cable, and then there's your power in. Do remember, obviously, if you're doing this way, they are ideally designed to be ceiling mounted, so you would need a power socket above the ceiling or close by. So you might want to consider actually powering this from a PoE switch, alternatively getting a PoE injector that allows you to keep the power down low and then just doing an Ethernet cable up to it. What else do we get? We get a packet of screws and lugs to mount this onto a hard surface. We get a packet of screws and plates if we want to mount this up onto a false ceiling, which I'll talk about in a moment. And we get a couple of other options for screws there depending on the surface that you are mounting it on, and then you are going to get your mounting plate here. So the idea again, you're going to screw this up onto your ceiling or to your hard surface, and then you're going to bring your device up to it, and it's actually going to swivel and lock into place. If you were wanting to maybe put this onto a false ceiling, you've got false ceiling tiles, then you're going to push this up to the tile, and hopefully you can see there's these discs that you get. You're going to get a number of these on the other side of the tile, and you're going to use the bolts and nuts in this packet to bolt that, and you'll end up with a sandwich with the tile there in the middle, and that will then allow you to connect the access point to it like that. So there's your hard surface mounting bracket, and then here's the access point at all. Beautiful little access point. Like I said, it's a wireless 6. We have on this side 12 volts in, so if you wanted to mains power this, all right, that's where you're going to plug your mains in. We have our PoE and LAN port. It's a 1 gig Ethernet port. This is how most people would power it. They're going to run an Ethernet cable in the ceiling and just pop it through, get the electrician to do that, and it's going to run the mains power there. That's probably the simplest way to do it. So mains is going to be right back near where your router is. It's going to go into a PoE switch or an injector and then be carried up that Ethernet cable to where you finally mount that. So that's your Ethernet port here, and then we've got our reset switch right the way over there. Beautiful size ceiling mount, probably not much to show you, lights up to show you what it's doing there on the front. Out the box, it does have some default settings there, so if you just want to use it basically, then you can just use the SSID and password that are on the unit, but I would suggest putting it in the Omada controller to get more out of it. Hopefully that's been useful to show you what's in the box for the TP-Link Wireless 6 EAP 610, a wireless 6 access point. Head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got plenty more box openings on wireless network and firewall devices. We've got What Do I Need to Run TP-Link Omada, where we talk about switches and PoE injectors and access points and how they all fit together. So do find some other videos over there. Subscribe and stay up to date.